Okay. Now, some of the features have also second position, which is not here visible. Then, for example, I want on this pins something different. I can check for the alternating position. The CubeMX advised me here to, for the alternating position show, use the control and click. Then I press the control, I click on the pin, and with the light blue, he tried to show me the alternate position. You can see that alternate position for the SPI1 missile is on the PB5 pin. Then if I drag there my pin, I here move the missile port, MOSI port on the PB5. I can check also if the missile have the same, yes, and the clock also. Then with this, I can move the SPI to the alternate position very easy. But sometimes I'm happy with the position, which is here. I can try, for example, check the pin in 17 later on. Sorry, first I disable the SPI. I disable here the pins. I enable the SPI again. Okay, and in case that I want CubeMX, for example, here I have collision between the SPI and also between the ADC. But I know that this SPI have the second alternate position. Then if I uncheck this keep user placement signal, then CubeMX try for me always optimize the pinout and move, for example, the SPI to the alternate position. Then if I here select the input 7, you can see he automatically moved my SPI signal to the alternate position, and I don't need to do this with my own. But in case that you don't want the CubeMX to optimize the pinout for you, you check here the keep user placement, and he cannot optimize the pinout for you. Okay, I here set my pinout, clear pinout, yes. Okay, then this is about pinout. I can here show you some additional functions in case that you, for example, select one pin as the output. You can, with the right click on this pin, also select the label when you can put your name, because GPIO output is not very good explanation about of this functionality. Then I can, for example, here put my LED. This PA4 will be my LED signal. Okay. Then here in the pinout menu, you can find more interesting functions. For example, in case you set the SPIs you set, you can here want few use the three pins for example output, but you want to use, for example, 10 pins, not only one, which you need to do that you 10 times click here and select output, which is annoying. Then in the pinout, you can here use the functionality set unused GPIOs. And here you can set how many GPIOs you want to set and what will be the functionality. In my case, for example, analog. And he set all unused pin into the output mode. I can again close my pinout. And this is all from this important from this step. Last part, I can show you here the USB host, how to activate it. He advised me to enable the USB full speed IP. Then, for example, if I here enable the USB, for example, as a device, Then here I can use the USB middleware stack, which is related to the USB. Without USB periphery, it's not necessary to have USB stack. Okay, then this is all from the pinout. We can jump to the second session part.